All right, we're back. So let's think this through. So the teacher gets to suggest to the student any question. The teacher knows the answer, and the teacher would like the learner to get the answer as quickly as possible, not requiring the full 20 questions if possible. So what do you think? What do you think the teacher could do as a good strategy here?
For 20 questions?
Yeah.
So if we think of the set of possible people as being these sort of hypotheses, and you know which of the hypotheses is correct and which is wrong, then presuming the teacher can keep all this in her head, I guess the right thing to do would be to always pick an X such that it gets rid of as many of the hypotheses as possible. But what do I mean by that? I mean, it gives the most information.
Well, but there's a very strong kind of information that you could get in this particular case. So let's imagine that the set of questions is the sort of, you can ask any question in the universe.
So I give you some questions.
Let's try this, because remember we did this before. You thought of a person, and you had me ask questions. So why don't you think of a person?
Okay.
All right, and I want you to tell me what question I should ask that's going to figure out who the person is as quickly as possible.
Okay. Is this person as good in his field as his namesake is in his field?
Is it Michael Jordan?
Yes.
Is it the Michael Jordan who's a professor at Berkeley?
Yes.
Okay.
You could have asked about it. Is it Michael I. Jordan?
Yeah, I don't think I know the initials of the two Michael Jordans.
Yeah. Michael Jordan, for people who don't know, is a professor at Berkeley and one of the giants in machine learning. And he is quite literally the Michael Jordan of machine learning.
All right. But you could have done this in one question, right? If you had to ask me, if the first question was, is the person and then the actual person, you knew that the answer to that would be yes. And so I would have gotten it in one step.
That's true.
So given a sufficiently helpful teacher, you can do this in one.
Well, that makes sense, right? So basically, if my questions include, is this the correct hypothesis, then you should always just ask that question.
Right.
But that seems like cheating.
Yeah, I you're right. And all I was really trying to do is show that it's a very different problem when the question has to come from the learner side. That kind of question from the learner side would be pure folly, because the learner would not know which person to pick. If the learner started to ask questions like, is the person Michael I. Jordan, the answer is very likely to be no, in which case that's not very helpful. Now, a really helpful teacher could potentially change the target, but that's definitely cheating.
Okay, fair enough.